Welcome again. Today we explain how flowering is controlled in long day and short day plants, including the role of phytochrome.
The Cocklebur,
Xanthium strumerium. In the 1930s, Banner and Hamner made a series of observations on the influence of light, or the lack of it, on this species. Today, we describe the Cocklebur as a short day plant because it requires a longer night to trigger its flowering. Responses of this kind are described as photoperiodism. When flowering is involved, this process is triggered or inhibited by concentrations of a complex macromolecule known as phytochrome. In the presence of sunlight, one form of phytochrome, referred to as phytochrome red, is converted into another form of phytochrome, phytochrome far red. Because sunlight contains significantly higher amounts of red light compared to far red light, during the daytime, the conversion of phytochrome red into phytochrome far red exceeds the reverse reaction. And as the day proceeds, the concentration of phytochrome far red builds up and the concentration of phytochrome red declines. Both are slightly different forms of the same molecule. And when phytochrome red is exposed to light of the appropriate frequency, it is converted into its isomer, phytochrome far red. A similar conversion drives phytochrome far red to become phytochrome red. This is very much a dynamic process, but the equilibrium is shifted towards phytochrome far red during the day, and concentrations build up during periods of sunlight. In the Cocklebur, phytochrome far red inhibits flowering. So when the days are very long, the concentration of phytochrome far red is always too high. At night, phytochrome far red is converted into phytochrome red. But if the night is too short, then this conversion is not sufficient to trigger flowering. As the seasons change, nights become long enough. The Cocklebur requires a critical amount of darkness, 9 hours or more of continuous darkness. So the term short day plant is somewhat misleading, for it is a critical period of darkness that triggers the flowering response. On the other hand, some plants like spinach and lettuce and the California poppy shown here will only flower when the days are long enough to build up high amounts of phytochrome far red. And when the concentration is high enough, flowering is triggered. Once the days are long enough, then the daily buildup of phytochrome far red creates a sufficient level so that despite the reverse reaction occurring at night, the concentration that was built up during the day is sufficient to trigger the flowering mechanism. These plants are referred to as long day plants because they are triggered by increasing day lengths, or more significantly, shorter periods of darkness. To master this topic, I would like you to click on the link to the TED Ed lesson in the caption below this video.